My name is Karin Wayne. I'm a genetic counselor at Geisinger and a member of the ClinGen Education Workgroup. This presentation will provide a brief introduction into how clinical genetics providers contribute to the interpretation of genomic variants, both by interacting as partners with the genetic laboratory and by incorporating variant interpretation activities into their own clinical workflow. The clinician has an important role in the clinical interpretation of genomic variants. One important way the clinician can contribute is to communicate effectively with the genetic testing lab and provide clinical details about a patient prior to testing. This can include sending clinic notes and pedigrees when requested, but also helping the lab understand nuances, such as which clinical features are most impressive. It can help to include genes or disorders that you are suspicious of, as well as pertinent negatives. And precise descriptions are more useful than general terms, like dysmorphic features. For genomic testing, such as exome and genome sequencing, this information may influence if and/or how a variant is interpreted. However, after a variant is reported, the clinical provider continues to have an important role in the clinical interpretation of that variant and how that interpretation is understood by patients, families, and other medical providers. While the pathogenicity of some genetic variants is well established, this is not true for the majority of variants. The clinician should understand the principles and the types of information used in variant interpretation, including how these have changed over time, and can incorporate variant interpretation activities into clinical practice. One way this is often done is through clinical correlation, assessing the clinical fit of a patient's clinical features and history with the disorder associated with a reported variant. This may involve pursuing additional clinical evaluations or revisiting the medical and family history with the patient. The clinician can provide this feedback and new clinical information to the testing lab so that it can be included in the laboratory internal data and used for subsequent interpretations. And a clinician can search for data not specifically outlined in a lab report or verify the interpretation of literature cited in the report in order to determine if they agree with the interpretation. If a variant's interpretation does not make sense, that would be a good opportunity to contact the laboratory to discuss. Test reports also represent an interpretation of a variant at a given point in time. They are static and may have been limited by older interpretation guidelines and a lack of available genomic data. Given the dynamic nature of the genomics field, it would be important for a clinician to recognize when a report seems outdated, either because of the use of outdated terms, such as mutation, or because the evidence outlined in the report does not support the interpretation based on current guidelines. A clinician may also want to prioritize certain variants and search for new data over time that would support or refute a potential role for a variant in a patient's health. Finally, the genetic professional's understanding of variant interpretation processes and resources can be very important in providing guidance to non-genetics colleagues and in counseling the patient or family. Translating the rationale for a variant's interpretation, particularly if it has changed, can help some patients adjust to new information, and it can positively impact rapport and trust. For patients with multiple reported variants, it can also help them understand why some variants are less concerning than others and allow them to focus their energy more effectively, especially if they want to join community genomic efforts or other research or support options. The purpose of this presentation does not include diving into the details of variant interpretation or each of the resources available to a clinician. Other ClinGen presentations are available or will be created with those goals. But I did want to touch on the key information that is needed when searching for data relevant to variant interpretations. These include the gene name, the transcript, coding or cDNA, and protein change nomenclature for sequence variants, and the genomic coordinates or nomenclature. Most of these details should be included on a lab report, although for sequence variants, genomic coordinates may not always be included. The resources along the right side of the slide can help you obtain genomic coordinates if needed. And always call the lab to clarify anything that doesn't make sense. This key information will be needed to search for a variant in population-based databases and case or patient databases, to use in silico or computational models if necessary, and to search for previous reports of a variant in the literature. Incorporating variant interpretation activities into clinical practice requires common sense. The goal is not to recreate the lab report or to mistrust the expertise of the genetics lab. It is to ensure that all information, including an informed clinician perspective, is fully integrated into the interpretation and to help ensure quality care over time. Therefore, supplement the lab report, don't recreate it. For example, it is reasonable to rely on the lab to evaluate and select in silico models. Consider the individual patient. Is their ethnic background well represented by current resources? Is the disease in question likely to be absent from population studies? How does the medical or family history fit with what is known about the impact of the specific variant type? Critically review the primary literature cited in a report and consider older interpretation trends, particularly the tendency to overinterpret variants in older literature. If you can't obtain data listed in a report, contact the lab. Genes of uncertain significance are frequently reported by exome and genome testing and are often included within copy number variant regions reported by chromosomal microarray. Population data can help you fine-tune your understanding of the potential clinical relevance of these genes by assessing overall variation in the population. Weigh the evidence that a particular type of variant would be expected to cause a disorder, since not all variant types have the same impact on a gene's function and may not have the same phenotypic consequences. And verify that a lab's interpretation makes sense with respect to your patient. I hope this has been a useful introduction into how genetics providers contribute to variant interpretations and how variant interpretation activities can be incorporated into clinical practice. Please visit www.clinicalgenome.org for additional educational resources and to learn more about ClinGen initiatives. Our funding sources are listed at the bottom. Please feel free to contact ClinGen by email at clingen@clinicalgenome.org with questions or feedback. Thank you.